Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. If you've been watching the series, you know I've been working almost nonstop on the Archivette, archiving a lot of cylinders and just continuing my experiments with the Archivette, trying to get the best use out of it possible, you know, seeing what it's actually capable of. But I need an acoustic recording to do an experiment with, and I figured since I needed an acoustic recording, I might as well set up the camera and video the process. So I'm recording on the Edison Home Phonograph, and I've installed a black wax dictation cylinder that's been trimmed and shaved, as usual, and these make really incredible recordings. They really do. And I did posted the surface noise on one of these just a few hours ago, and I had the volume turned up all the way on the Archivette. Just so you could hear it. The surface is virtually noiseless. Really quite incredible. But in any case, I need an acoustic recording to do an experiment with. I'm going to be playing it back through a horn, but then I will be also eventually be playing it back with the Archivette. So I'm going to record with the speaking tube. I'm just going to make about a minute voice recording. I'm using the Canophonic voice recorder. I'm recording on the Edison Home B phonograph. Now, I don't usually record on this, but the standard B has the MP3 recorder on it, and I just wanted to do a quick acoustic recording. So I figured since the Home B was sitting there not doing anything, I'd just record on that. As I said, I'm using the Canophonic voice recorder, I'm using the speaking tube, and this is one of the early ones with the brass bell. But I keep this one here on the desk, so I'll be using this one for most of the voice recordings that I do with the speaking tube. But the machine is fully wound, the blank is installed, so just going to do a quick recording, just about a minute or so. I just need an acoustic recording to use for one of my experiments. Greetings and salutations, this is Benjamin the Victrola Guy, making an acoustic recording on the Edison Home cylinder phonograph. I'm recording on a black wax cylinder. This is a shaved and trimmed Edison Edifone dictation cylinder. I've trimmed it and shaved it for use on the Edison Home phonograph. Recording on the Edison Home B, and I'm recording with a speaking tube. This is one of my early speaking tubes with the brass bell. But this is the one I keep on the desk, so it was handy, as was the machine. The Edison Standard B, my dedicated recorder, actually has the MP3 transfer recorder on it. And so I just wanted to do a quick acoustic recording for playback, first through a horn and then through the Archivette. Just doing a quick experiment to fine-tune the parameters of the Archivette and just make sure I can get the best possible recordings possible. So, in any case, recording this on the Edison Home B cylinder phonograph, I don't usually record on this machine. I try to keep it fairly clean, and whenever I record, it makes a great deal of swarf. And this swarf gets down into every moving part. It gets into the motor, it gets into the mandrel, it gets into the governor, gets into the winding gears. It just seems to migrate throughout the machine. The standard D that I use for recording is just absolutely covered with swarf. So every few weeks, you have to really clean it to get all the accumulated wax out of the gearing. So in any case, just a quick recording on a black wax cylinder. This is Benjamin, the Victrola Guy, doing a quick recording on the Edison Home B cylinder phonograph. This is October the 7th, I think. I wouldn't swear to that. 2012. It is 7:56 p.m. All right. So we stop the machine, remove the speaking tube, remove the recorder, of course. And this is the Canophonic voice recorder. And when you record with this, or actually when you record with any recorder, it generates a lot of swarf. And unfortunately, as I said, that swarf gets into everything. It's covering the cylinder. It gets down into virtually every major part. And it's so small, what you can't blow away, you have to eventually wipe off. And the thing is, as soon as you touch it, it just seems to melt right into the surface of the wood, or the metal for that matter. So you blow off as much as you can, and the rest of it actually takes some cleaning to get it off. So we blow the swarf off, grab a swarf brush. And this should be a fairly decent recording. The Canophonic voice recorder with a speaking tube produces a really decent voice recording. It doesn't have the tonal quality of a recording you get with a horn. But as far as clarity, it produces an exceptionally good voice recorder. Alright, let's grab a Model C reproducer. And I've got an original witch's hat horn here. Let me get out of the shot and just play back this recording. Like I said, I just need a recording for one of my experiments, but I figured since I was going to have to make one, I'd go ahead and make a video. Recording to be recorded with a speaking tube on a machine that's 108 years old. It's interesting recording on the Edison phonograph. There's just nothing else like it. So what I needed was an acoustic recording, so now I'm going to be playing this back with the Archivette, and it gives me a chance to do some fine tuning and some continuing experiments. But in any case, like I said, since I had to make a cylinder recording, I thought I'd go ahead and make a video of it. You know, I encourage everyone to, if you have an Edison phonograph, it doesn't take much to begin recording. An Edison recorder, you can find them on eBay. A blank wax cylinder, which I have plenty of, so if you're considering getting into recording, the blank wax are $20 a piece. The recorders, as I said, you can find them on eBay. I'll be offering a recorder of my own. Once it comes back from Switzerland, I had no idea it was going to take this long. But in any case, like I said, I needed an acoustic recording for use with the Archivette. And the Canophonic voice recorder and this old machine make pretty high-quality voice recordings. It's always impressive to think of the technology involved and yet these recordings can equal a tape recorder. It's a lot of fun. It's really interesting and it's really historic. And there's not enough people involved. I try to encourage virtually anyone that has any interest at all. Record on the Edison phonograph. It is a lot of fun. So, in any case, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email at victorlaguy@gmail.com. Answer all of my email. Try to answer today. I get it. Any questions about recording on the Edison phonograph? Never too busy to answer the simplest question. It's always interesting to see the people who are beginning to record on the phonograph. And I get email about shaving Edison cylinders, recording on them, how to record music, etc., etc. It's always interesting. But as I said, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email to victrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.